Yeah, I've found my assistance by asking people that I trust if they know anybody that's a great engineer. And I realized that I prefer people that are very green. They haven't had much. Like one of my second out of three assistants I've had didn't even know Pro Tools before he met me. Yeah. Used Ableton quite well as a producer, but not necessarily as an engineer, and never touched Pro Tools, and that was amazing. So Ingmar uses Pro Tools like I do, so it's just really an efficient collaboration. And now we're doing a fair share of Atmos mixes together, and I get him some mix work and send things his way that don't. But you know, maybe they can't afford me, or it's not something that I think that I'm well suited for, and we can communicate on them when we're working together because of that language that we spoke, that we delivered, developed together.
So let's talk about that real quick. As maybe in the macro, how do people get hired as assistants? It seems like what you're saying, and I'll sort of expand out of this. There's the other thing with a lot of this is what we're actually talking about is the hiring process and building teams. And that's something that I think John and I can speak to in our realms, but it actually varies quite a bit based on the temperament yeah. of whoever's running the organization, whether that's a producer or an engineer or a songwriter or a record label or any of these sorts of things. And not just the organization, but people will have different needs and desires. I think for me, I'm very similar, I assume similar to you, in the sense that when I've hired people or wanted to collaborate with people, if the idea is we're going to work on something long term, if you hire someone for a project or work on a project, I'm looking for a skill or a task to get done, and I'm going to try to hire the person who is most likely to be able to execute that. But mm-hmm. if you're talking about long-term relationships, which is what an assistant is, or the mentor-assistant relationship, I think what you're really looking for is work ethic and personality. Because if someone has the drive and the excitement and they're pleasant to be around and they're going to be reliable and work hard, you can kind of teach them anything. They can learn yes. anything. So the idea of like having a Pro Tools certification may be important for it might be important for some things. If you're going to get an assistant job at a studio, they need you to know how to use Pro Tools before you get there. But usually, if you're working for a person, if you show the ability to, you know, I imagine that having Pro Tools proficiency is by and large going to be a good thing. But there are many exceptions to it, and it's not going to be as important as being able to show up on time, excited, you know, and be able to adapt to the person that you might be working for.